Welcome, good people. Welcome back to Broken Windows. I'm your host, Chadrack Manano.
Joel Otim is my name.
And today we have a special guest.
Very special.
It's one Christmas. And only.
Tendo Teo.
My name is Tendo Rachel. Teo, not
Teo. Come on, it depends on which primary school you went to. We played a lot of money.
Introduced
themselves
like in Sunday school.
What else should I say?
The people just want to know. That's all they want to know.
Yeah,
they trust you.
Okay.
By the time you're here, they trust you.
Okay.
You're here to help us dig deep.
Deeper.
Yes. How was your week though?
It has been okay, really boring. There is really nothing to tell them about, so it's okay. It has been
just the normal things, washing plates.
Mopping.
Bend over on these things also. I decided to mop when you were right. That place is dirty much. Why did you do that?
Like, speaking of mopping, though it has been wet.
You want to mop the whole town?
No, but the whole town has been wet.
It has been flooding, man. It's no longer cats and dogs.
I'm starting to believe we're not talking about weather. Are we still talking
about weather?
We're talking about weather. Speaking of wetness, being wet. One of the things that kept me warm was these pictures of Bash.
That guy deserves a medal.
Have you seen those pictures?
I have seen them.
Have you also tried to
pose? I have never.
That's what we're going to hear.
But before even continue, tell me, you just said you've never posed.
I've never posed.
So not for a camera, but I mean like for your own personal benefit. After showering, you just said, you know, shaped well. Not bad.
Ignore him.
I have never.
How about as you grow? These are some things you
maybe I have not yet, but you know, maybe.
But when you decide to do it, ask Bash, because that guy is doing
something. That guy deserves a hero's hour.
He's doing something. I don't know what they pour oil on these girls.
That's
all.
Saddest part is, I feel like one day. Police is going to come. He's going to be chilling there, and they're going to come and arrest him.
For what?
Pornography.
Pornography.
How do you think they're looking at
pornography? That is an artistic culture. No, for real. If you look at art, back in an idea, the Italian art, German, and all those things in Greece and all, they were naked. There's that kind of artistic thing with the casino.
Those things.
Biko coming.
That was a god, yo. Respect them.
Exactly, you see.
But yo, those pictures look nice. Still, I saw that before picture. Did you see that before picture?
It seems you're the only one who has it.
I did research.
He has a guy behind you.
You always have guys. But no, people are rioting. Why are people even
rioting? I really think when it comes to these things, you have to. There's always going to be someone who does not approve of what you do. And we're living in this African society where showing parts of your, you know, private parts
of your creation
is deemed immoral, is deemed wrong. So of course you cannot expect like the old people to appreciate that. That's you see, now for us we're living in a changing world where we know that's art. That is you know what
it's not art. So, it's not a profanity. It's not art.
You know, it could be also appreciation because I know a couple of people who have nude pictures. Artistic ones,
so they
and they're like framed somewhere in their houses.
Yes,
big. I never visit this before.
This is why you don't let me visit.
But you see, that's there's always someone who is not going to
appreciate
what you do. Yeah, and of course, when it comes to you know what, for example, what Bash is you know is doing, and recently there was a time on Twitter people as if were attacking him, and then he came out to say, the same people who are attacking me here, the same people who are asking me to save their numbers so that they can view my statuses. Yeah? And like when I read that
do you know anyone who knows
I do actually, so talk to me nicely, but as you actually continue,
you say you wouldn't take such a picture.
I wouldn't.
But would such pictures influence your sexual urge?
Now, if I were a man, I would. Yeah. So definitely, I know there are thousands of men like the two of you. The fact that we're having this discussion means we have appreciated. I'm not going to appreciate
those
images,
but
like you would.
Appreciation does not necessarily come with a soap package. Sometimes you just appreciate.
That is true.
But talk about it in a context of now we have an anti-pornography act.
Yeah.
Father Lokondo, first of all, that
guy looked for ninjas, no miniskirts. He has gone back to his
life. You know, like the other guy was just handing out free
cards. That guy passed.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. You should have been like the other guy. And your father local to anti-pornography, they talked about a machine. They're bringing a machine. You can see what.
I really try to distance myself from any job that requires a government procurement, because for it to reach here, they will first steal some money, then they will get money to get a commission of inquiry to look for the other money, then the money that was given to those people also gets lost.
And then, you are really tired. I'm tired.
We just want to thank Bash for the good work he's doing. But if it was a guy, would you want Bash? So is it your prayer that Bash starts taking guys? And how would you want to suppose?
Okay, yes. For me, like on a personal level, I don't take sexual arousal through images, through videos, that is why.
I want this t-shirt for that.
Why did you want to show your throat?
That is why, to me, I don't think you will ever find me watching porn.
Let me watch you.
No, let me tell you. Now, let's first focus on porn. Yeah. For me personally, this is a story I really thought I was like, should I share it? Should I not? Because I know probably some aunties somewhere may land on this video and be like,
Auntie Gundi to Bulawa Nyo.
I was exposed to porn at a young age, because I remember I think it was around P5, that's when I started watching porn. Now, I wasn't watching porn because...
That's when you started watching porn.
Yes. Now, I wasn't watching porn because white people watch porn to get sexual arousal or whatever. By then, I was kind of a tomboy, so I used to hang with boys. Yeah, and of course the school I was in, we had our phones, we had internet, we had so I was influenced. So at the end of the day, like let me say after a weekend, it's a Monday, we're there lunchtime jazzing, you know, guys are talking about this car website. So I said watching porn to fit in with my friends. Yeah, so that at the end of the day, I used to be like, hey, by the way, there's this car link. Yeah, so it wasn't because I wanted to, but it's because of, you know, I really wanted to just fix
it.
And I feel like this happens to so many people. Yeah? Because you see, when I say that, don't watch porn, all of you are like, aah! As if...
No, there are
so many people who watch porn just to fit in. Yeah?
Explain to me this. How is someone watching? Okay, yes, as children, as adolescents, we're watching porn. This is all like influence.
Yeah.
But now as an adult, you're not watching porn to fit in.
Yeah, but
good,
now...
But also,
people keep having this conversation.
Okay, but also porn in Uganda. Because we have gone from watching porn now to one actual representation in porn. But when they go, we're speaking Uganda.
Blue, they're there.
With the kind of law that we have, that is not about to happen.
No, but there's only fans.
Okay, let's go down.
Before we actually go down, Madam started watching at 5. How about you?
At 5,
Let me see. I'm not sure.
You cannot forget this.
No, but it was in holiday. I can tell you when, but it was in holiday. I can't tell you which class. Probably like P4.
Yeah.
My big cousin.
Me, it was actually hard. That is why I think I remained a man of a stout. But my dad being a reverend, it was actually very high. And my uncles who were staying with us back then, they were actually like, it's a dip. We are from the edges of this. So they would label those things different because our dad is not allowed us to watch violent things. So they would put it as either Tyson versus Holyfield. So we say, I cannot watch Tyson. No. But sometimes when I saw Tyson, it was a different ninja. We came for one. There's no fight. But people are still screaming. Anyway, so if you're saying that the content is no longer that, OnlyFans has actually come up to take us on.
Do you know that OnlyFans has paid out like $600 million to people?
How do you know we like, never get this money?
For you, what do you have to showcase? Well, that is showcasing.
So what is OnlyFans about?
OnlyFans is like a crowdfunding platform. Basically, you can get an account on OnlyFans. That's what you do with social media.
Yeah.
And then you'll be posting content, pictures, videos, whatever, audios.
Then, like,
the most
content.
Views. Yes. The most
pornographic. They don't
limit.
They don't limit. But obviously, it's mostly pornographic.
Because it sells.
OnlyFans.
Yeah.
Because it sells. Yes. Yeah.
So wait, the most views you have?
No. Your people just pay you. It's almost like a membership only club. So they'll get like.
My fans pay me for exactly. If I post, yeah. You know, for media exactly. That they like, they pay me so that they can continue watching my content.
Exactly. So, but I was reading this article, there's like a whole sort of industry behind it. These like big sort of OnlyFans stars, they do intimacy, they will send you birthday cards on your birthday. They'll call you and welcome you back home after you've been sick.
People actually grow personal relations with their fans.
There are 200,000 people every day joining adult platforms like OnlyFans. 200,000 people in the world.
Shit.
That means after here, one of us has to go and
join. One of us has to go and join. Hey, the camera guys. What the hell?
Tyson.
I know Tyson.
I think we should take this.
But yeah, it's a very big idea. Recently, some two Hollywood celebs caused issues because OnlyFans and like porn has been like this thing of society that people like ignore that, like it's for the lesser people. What was this babe Bella Thorne?
Yeah,
she went open an account, 24 hours, $1 million. 2 weeks, 2 million. You know what she posted?
What?
A picture of her in lingerie. Only that. Then she took all her money. Then we were like, our money. Ugandans must have been like 80%. They were doing the money for the money. But did they get it back?
Yes. But she did what she wanted. We wanted to stay with them. We wanted her to get personal with them because they've seen her lingerie.
But if, imagine if Beyonce joined OnlyFans, it would break the internet.
That's why in her song she said with Savage, the remix, she said, I could start an OnlyFans. And by then I was like, where OnlyFans? You know when you're just singing lyrics and you just don't understand, and then later on I found out what OnlyFans meant. I was just like, okay, this.
But
let me tell
you, see, OnlyFans for me is different from porn because OnlyFans you're not really watching porn. You're more like watching people. Like if I told you,
hey, in porn you'll be watching, right?
No, you'll be. No. You'll be watching people, but you're watching like porn stars. But yeah. If like they told you you're some guy in your cell has an OnlyFans, you go and pay for that guy.
Do you know that not every person in a porno is a porn star?
And exactly.
You
exactly.
See, there are actually pornos that are recorded live and sometimes
sex tapes, yes.
Yeah, like some sort of sex tape.
Oh, you record a sex tape?
Would I?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
I don't think so, Karunde.
I would.
Exactly.
If I had that level, trust. Because, man, these days you can't trust nobody.
But you know that all these things we put up in the net, even if you delete them, they stay somewhere.
They're
resurrected.
But you see,
but I really think you would have to be somebody for them to resurrect it.
Yeah.
I feel like even if my things went out now and you know people don't know about it.
Let me shock you. The first episode we ever did.
Yeah.
Remember the first episode we commented like was a porn
star.
In the comments, yeah. You can go and check out that video.
The first
Okay, now this is you're starting to make me question. Why are you attracting such people?
We attract everyone.
We shall keep the details later, but one of us.
This guy is a Mike Tyson of four. No, no.
This is the Mayweather.
Okay, but if you're like on a serious note, though, away from jokes, would you? What is your say on porn, on pornography? What effects does it have? What do you think porn? You know, of course, there are two sides to every coin.
Yeah.
So, what is the percentage of the good to bad in your view?
And in my view, let me start. In my view, I think, or I believe, man, porn is bad.
Yeah.
Anything you can't control.
Exactly.
At a later point, yeah, it's bad. It's good if probably you've just checked in, yeah, like the first time, like, hey, these are new things people are doing. Okay. They also utilize the nose.
Yeah, the curiosity.
The curiosity, I know.
Exactly. They utilize the what?
I'm just.
Okay.
Yeah, like other holes, nose, ear.
What?
Chill.
Why?
Anyway, but once you go deep into it, it actually starts controlling your life at certain points, even when you're not watching. But because you had actually programmed yourself to watch porn at probably 9:30, this time you're in a serious meeting, and you just get an involuntary reaction
it can be an addiction.
But now if probably you're watching it probably with your partner to probably enhance your sexual life, the two people who are like Joel Santoni, who was a virgin, I hope he's watching.
But on this thing of watching, you remember when Pastor Martin Semper was showing people porn in church? I was like,
what? What is going on?
Get porn. Guys are like, ah, you guys, this is
bad.
Like, this guy can't just tell us about it and we believe what?
Yeah. So for you ask my girl, you what do you think about porn?
For me, the thing that scares me about porn is how it's not regulated as an industry. For example, like OnlyFans, because people are paying people to do like the weirdest like sexual fantasies.
Yeah.
It's almost like it's even far from prostitution, because prostitution is like sexual gratification.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you're paying someone on OnlyFans to send you birthday wishes, to do all these weird things, to know your kids' names, it's almost like a weird sex slave thing. Yeah. We're not different from R. Kelly now.
You brought Robert here.
But you see, me, I think, you know, just like I said, the two sides to a coin. I think the good, okay, it may not be good, but the truth is, porn is like the best form of sex education that we have.
That is true.
Yeah, we're living in African societies where our parents are shy, or they don't, you know, they're never comfortable to talk about sex with us. They're never comfortable to tell us, this is what happens here. These things only happen now for us in Uganda. These things only happen when you're going to get married, and then they call us Senga. But it doesn't even reach the point that they are
Sengas.
Sengas that they hire. Like your own Senga is not bold enough
to have this conversation
with you. So they have to hire out Sengas, and that's why so many that Senga Koja business is booming. Yeah. So that's why I feel like it's one of the only actual, you know, sex education platforms that we have.
Before we even proceed, recently, actually a week ago, this lady, Bad Black, was being lauded by Uganda King.
Yeah.
They gave her a certificate. You're overstaying here. Let me first finish.
Yeah.
And the reason they're giving her was for promoting the morals, promoting the traditions and cultures of Uganda. And I sat back and said, which ones exactly are we talking about?
I don't think it's just the plain bad black Snapchat that we watch.
Uh-huh.
Definitely,
she's very educated.
She's very influential. Bad Black is a possible singer. That at the end of the day, she's not afraid to say this thing. She's not afraid to come and tell you, you know,
big up to the Buganda Kingdom, because that means that we're not living in a society where we act like the oldest profession known to man is not there. We need prostitution to be there so that marriages can remain stable, governments can remain stable.
Governments can remain stable.
Yes.
No,
Have you listened to Bad Blood? So we talk about ministers.
Ministers, man, she exposed some ninjas. She first said Mike Mugula uses Viagra.
Okay. Let's go back to phone and OnlyFans. You mean that women only fans accounts? Like very many women and have only fans accounts.
But you went through and searching for them.
I did my research, my dear. I did my research.
But then again, yeah, I think, of course, as you say, porn is, you know, is just like any other job.
Yeah,
could get addicted to it. It has so many, you know.
And I feel it's like it affects men a lot.
Yeah, but I also think that generally porn has made us, what? How should I say it? It has created a certain world that if I don't do this like that, then I'm doing sex all wrong.
Yeah.
We have lost the sense of creativity because I mean sex is supposed to be, you know, kind of unique to
exploration.
Yes, yeah. Unique to two people. Two people love themselves, they feel a certain way, they come together and try out whatever, you know, just go with the flow. But because of porn, it has made, you know, people seem like if you do not come like this, it has dictated how sex should be, and that is the biggest disadvantage. I feel like
we need to talk openly more about like porn and how it affects people or society basically.
Yeah.
Because if we do not do that, then we get into situations where people are paying other people to eat.
Yeah. Naked. Because now you could.
There's a guy who made a lot of money just from eating naked. People are getting off on the weirdest.
You see, it's creating some, even the fetishes, you know, they're always new.
What
things,
is a fetish?
Yeah.
About another day.
They're always new. But on a real though, there are always new things on these porn sites and what.
Yeah.
And if let me say a young man goes, you know, to watch porn, he has a plan tomorrow, and also
like some of these fetishes reflect our society.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times the most popular like tags on porn sites are like incest, funny things like this. And you know what kills me most?
Mother burns son, and you just like, what?
You know what kills me most is that in Saudi Arabia the most popular kind of porn is gay porn.
And yet there is
the
gay and homosexual in Saudi Arabia, you're banned. You're literally killed. But that is the much worse thing. I think when you refuse people to do things, they will actually start.
And I actually think porn could also play a big role in domestic violence in, you know, in families.
BDSM.
Yeah, just even, BDSM kind of thing. Even those weird things, those weird fetishes of son, you know, I mean father and daughter. You know, just imagine we have been in quarantine, lockdown, everyone.
The underbelly of porn is like a very, it's a very dangerous thing.
And I think
this conversation would have to continue longer. If
yes.
I know.
Yes. There's like a lot that we need to
we have to cut this conversation short and come early.
Yeah. You late comers,
guys, tell us what you think about porn and everything in the comment section. Make sure to follow Broken Windows.
And those who are in church when Pastor Semba played that thing, tell us
about it. We thank our guest Tendo for coming through and just educating us. It's always a pleasure.
And to have a singer with us.